Happy morning, children. How are you all doing? Hope you all are doing good. Okay. Fine, children. Yes. In the last class, we have started with the history. Okay. So, what are all the cons? I know the concept we have learned in the last class, children. Just an introduction we have seen. And as I told you, people, today we are going to see the reasons or how in the France, the people has been divided like a category wise. There are three estates. The people has been divided into three estates or the three groups that we'll be seeing, and the system they were following that we'll call it as a feudal system that we'll see. In the last class, we have seen that in France, what happened? Yes, the destroyer, destruction of Bastille we have seen. So, what is the main cause for the destruction of the Bastille, children? So, that we'll be seeing, okay? So, as I told you, people, without any reason, nothing will happen. Yes or no, children? So, there should be some certain reasons or the causes for an event. So, the same way, the destruction of the Bastille did not happen in a single day. They had some lot of reasons behind that. So in today's class, we are going to see, in this entire chapter, we'll be seeing about the reasons. But in today's class, we'll be seeing how the people has been divided and what is the, the system they were following. Everything we'll see today. Okay. Yes. The same continuation chapter, that is French Revolution. See. Yes, children. So in today's class, we'll be seeing about a society of estates we'll be seeing, and then the feudal system, that is very much important concept. And later we'll see about the struggle to survive, how the people were struggling just to survive, just to lead their life. Okay, and we'll go for recapitulation. Yes, children. So this system is called as a feudal system. So here what happens, children? Feudal system. There is a king. So as we already know that in each, the earlier, in each country, we were following, the maximum we were following about monarchy. What do you mean by monarchy? There are different kinds of government. So monarchy is also one of that. What do you mean by monarchy, children? Already you have learned this concept in your civics in detail. Yes or no? So what do you mean by monarchy? Yes, that is a single power will be ruling the entire country. That is called as a monarchy. So here that single power we call it as a king. Okay, the king or the queens will be ruling the entire country. So in France, who was the king that time? Louis 16. Okay. So the kings and the queens will be ruling the entire country. After that, we can see that the tenants and the chiefs, and then we can see knights, that is the landlords. Even we'll be seeing this tenants and chief, we call it as a vassals. Guys, remember, we even call this as a vassals, that is the landlords. And then the final, this is peasants. Okay. This category will be called as a peasant. So this pattern we call it as a feudal system. So in detail I'll be explaining you in the further, the next slide. See here, children. So here what happens? The peasants, as I told you people, they have divided into three estates. One it is clergies, that is the first estate. Second one it is nobilities, and the third it is peasants, are the remaining people. The remaining everyone will be considered as a third estate group. So the first estate, the clergies, we call it as a, yes, they are the, the church, the priest, we call it as a priest. The church, the fathers, they count as a the first estate groups. And the second estate group is the nobility people. Okay, that is the landlords. And the third estate people are the remaining people. That is, it may be the officers, or it may be some small manufacturing people, or it may be the landless people. The remaining everyone we consider in the third estate. Okay, see here. Peasants made up of 90% of the population. That is, the third estate people were almost 90%. Guys, remember, 90% of the people were third estate people. However, only a small number of them owned the land they cultivated. Okay, so only the few people, the small number of people having the land, or owned the land which they were cultivating. The remaining, the maximum, the land was owned by clergies. That is the first estate. The second one, it is the nobility people. That is the landlords. And even in the third estate also, there are few rich people. Okay, those people were having the land. See here, about 60% of the land was owned by nobles. That is the landlords. That is second estate people. And the church, that is the nobility, you know, the clergies, and the other richer member of the third estate. Only the few richer members of the third estate. Okay, guys, you people understood, right? This is clergy people. They are the priests. Okay, and the second one, it is nobility people. They are the landlords. And the third estate people, the remaining every people will be considered as the third estate people. Okay, that is peasants. Hope you guys understood, right? Yes, children. And the next one, it is the members of the first two estates, that is the clergy and the nobility, enjoyed certain privileges by birth. So as I told you people, the clergies and the nobility people are the very powerful people, very rich people, and they have got the lot of privileges, that is some advantages by the birth. Okay, by birth itself they were getting some advantages or the privileges. But coming to the third estate people, they didn't have any privileges or the advantages, because only the third estate people has to work for the first two estate people. Hope you guys are understanding, right? First two estate, that is the clergy and the nobility people, have got some, you know, the privileges or advantages by birth. Okay, by the birth itself, they have got some rights or some advantages, some privileges. But the third estate people were not having any privileges. Okay, hope you guys are understanding, right, children? Yes. And the next one, it is, see, in that the most important of this was exemption from paying taxes to the state. So guys, you people understanding, right? The first two estate, that is the clergy and the nobility people, they have got the privileges by birth. Along with that, you know, what is that? The most important, you know, the privilege they have got is exemption from paying the taxes to the state. They were not, you know, compelled to pay the taxes to the government or the state. Okay, this people, the clergy and the nobility people, were exempted to pay the taxes to the government. Hope you guys understood, right? Yes, children. See here. The nobles further enjoyed feudal privileges. This included feudal dues which they extracted from the peasants. So finally, as we have seen that, we have seen the division of the people and the feudal system. What is the feudal system? King was there. After a king, the vassals. And the third one, it is like a knights was there, and then this peasants was there. King, what happens? Whatever the feudal privileges these nobles were enjoying, they have got, they were extracting all this, you know, the privileges from the peasants, that is from the third estate people. Okay, See, in detail, I'll explain you people the feudal system with the pyramid, you know, the diagram. See in the next, okay? Peasants were obliged to render services to the lord, to work in his house and fields, to serve in the army, or to participate in building roads. Okay, so hope you guys are understanding right. Only the first two estate people are the privileged people, and they have got the privileges by birth itself. Okay, and they are exempted to pay the taxes to the states, and they are getting some services from the peasants, that is the third estate people. The third estate people known for what are the work they have to do? They have to give services to the nobility people and even the clergy people, and then they have to work in their houses, and they have to work in their fields, and they have to give services. They have to serve even in the army also. Only the third estate people were serving in the army, and they have to participate in building roads and construction works and all those things. Okay, hope you guys are understanding the differences between this three estate people. Okay, fine children. See, this is very much important concept, children. Okay, see here, the church too extracted its share of taxes called pits. Guys, remember, what do you mean by pit? This is a tax which the peasants has to pay to the church. Okay, guys, understand? See, the church was extracting the share of taxes called pits from the peasants. Only the third estate people were paying the taxes. And finally, all members of the third estate had to pay the taxes to the state. So as we know, the first two estate people were exempted to pay the taxes. Okay, first two estate people were exempted to pay the taxes. Only the third estate people were paying the taxes. Okay, tithes. See here, tithes. This is a kind of tax. This taxes was paid by peasants. Guys, remember, this is a kind of tax was paid by peasants to the churches. Okay, they were paying to the churches. So this kind of tax is called as tithes. Hope you guys are understanding right. Guys, remember, tithes. So even more, you know, the one more kind of the tills will also come. That is also kind of tax. That is a direct tax the peasants has to pay to the landlords. Okay, here the peasants, the third estate people, are paying more and more tax to the state, and only third estate people has to pay the tax, and all the third estate people has to pay the tax. Hope you guys are understanding right. So in the 18th century in France, the people has divided into three sectors or three categories. One, it is the first one, it is clergy. Second one, it is nobilities. And the third one, it is peasants. The first one is the clergy people. Are who are the clergy people? That is the priests, are the, you know, the churches, owners of the church, fathers of the church, and the priests will be considered as a clergy people. And the second one, the nobility people, they are called as a landlords. Okay, vessels. We even call them as a vessels also. They are also like a landlords. Okay, the second one, nobility people are, yes, the landlords. And the third one, it is peasants, the remaining people, whomever it may be, the officers, it may be the workers, it may be the, you know, the lawyers and the small landless people and the workers. All these people has considered in a third estate, that is